Welcome to Gord Field in Detroit Rock, Michigan. Nice town, isn't it, Bricks?
Well, by nice, you mean a town that would welcome you by cold cocking you in the head with a vacuum cleaner and stealing your luggage in the middle of a motel check-in and throwing you off the bridge into a polluted lake while enjoying your morning walk to the stadium? Then yes, Grin, very nice town. Couldn't be lovelier.
Today's matchup is going to be complete mayhem. The teams are taking the field. The Midway Mutants battle the Motor City Maniacs. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. It's time to tune in, turn on, and drop what you're doing, because NFL Game Day is on the air. Hi, everyone. Grim Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. So what's the game plan for the home team today, Bricks?
I think they gotta keep it simple. A little cough syrup, maybe smoke a little untidy pod pregame so they can keep their heads in the game. I mean, literally, you don't want to get decapitated on the opening kickoff.
I say go after the refs early and often. No mercy.
The defense better watch out. The quarterback just threw a murder ball.
I love the murder ball, 33.
Boom to the moon. Another loser fights the dust. In the NFL, winning is really about how much you want it, Bricks.
Well, he clearly didn't want to live as much as the other guy. That's a good point, Grim.
First and 10. Talking about Butterfingers, he should have had that one. Second down and 10. There aren't too many players that kids can look up to, and he breaks away. They go to the ground game and pick up the first. Nicely done. First and 10. Oh, with the punishing hit. Second and 3.
Was you can't kill the messenger because he's gonna kill you, but then he won't be able to read the message because the messenger killed him. Going in circles.
And it's first and 10. Try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
This guy's a brick shithouse.
One of the leading causes of death for mutants over 25?
I didn't know that.
Yeah, right below attending bachelor parties and owning a Sam Schlong Galaxy phone.
And it's first and 10. But defensive players go berserk. They've been known to rip the hands. Oh, and he intercepts the ball.
Thank you very much, Sister Defender.
And the NFL keeps pounding out the death hits on WMFL 98.8. The greatest hits of all time.
Huh? Did you just say greatest hits? Wow.
And it's first and 10. Up 9 yards on that catch. And that'll bring up second and one. First down. Give this guy a few catches and watch his confidence take off. He is deadly in the open field, Bricks. And it's first and 10. Nice pickup for 6 yards. And that'll be second down and 4.
One time, when I was playing, a guy hit me so hard, I wasn't the...
Oh, no, that was totally unnecessary. I gotta see that one again.
It was also freaking awesome. I hope they have raincoats in the front row, because that was splattering everywhere.
First down and 5. Ooh, that hit's gonna shave a few days off his life. Second and 3. Oh, great catch! And that's a touchdown! Touchdown!
Yeah, man, he's gonna hit him now.
Now, there are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth 7.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sitters then.
The kick is good!
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. Not a bad kick, but not a great one either.
Well, his nickname is Lukewarm.
And he's proud of that?
Yeah, that's why he named his clothing company Lukewarm Threads. Their marketing team hates it.
And it's first and 10. At this rate, the QB's gonna have more interceptions than completions. My friends, was an all-pro NFL hit. And it's first and 10. He picks up a 2. Second and 8 to go. And it's another pick. Man, oh man, the defense is going to have more receptions than the offense. And that was a bone crusher right there, folks. First and 10. He might have managed to dig out a yard on that one.
Not my yard. Got too much buried in, you know, the usual money, bodies, coffee cans filled with, well, you know, mostly coffee. Tastes better, like Eskimos burying salmon heads, kimchi. I mean, anything really tastes good.
The receiver runs away from the pass marker? That's a good clue that Sutton's not right.
Down and 9. sometimes the best thing to do is just punt and let your defense get the ball back. He boomed that one. Let's see if they can get nice catch, and he turns on the afterburner. Pow! With the brain scrambler. And it's first and 10. And that's another turnover for the defense. And he punched his way out of that. Oh, and he just left an outline on the ground like he was trying to wipe up. Since when is that a penalty?
Since now, I guess, Grim.
First down and inches. It's a jailbreak. And the defense jumps offside to kill the ref. Oh, crowd's loving it. And it's first and 10. When it feels like to have your teeth removed without Novocaine.
If I had all my teeth knocked out like that, I'd have them made into dice, Grim. It'd be fun to gamble with my own teeth.
Third and 2.
Republican congressman hits the airport men's room. Good and hard. First down.
That's the end of quarter one. Well, the good news is there's still time to make it a game.
And there's still time to get a beer.
And it's first and 10. Well, that was it. Second down and 10. And the quarterback throws another pick. He should have been. Oh, that was a big hit. Hey, Bricks, I bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career.
Let's see. About a quarter after 3, Grim. But my watch is a bit slow.
And it's first and 10. Look at that little mutant run!
I don't think you can say that, Grim!
And it's first and 10. Second down and more than the QB would like. That pass play was good for 3 yards. Down and 9. I've had it. I'm running out of excuses for this QB. You just. And he sends him to the ground with an. Come on, that was a cheap shot. That's why I love this guy. And so do the fans. And it's first and 10. For a couple of yards. And that'll be second and 8 to go. Third down and long. Now the offense is getting kills. The It's first and 10. Oh, man, what a throw. Oh, great throw. Great catch. And that puts 6 points on the board.
The defense couldn't do anything to stop a throw that good, Ben.
You mean aside from priming the ref, killing the quarterback, or actually playing some D?
Mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chip wearing a wig.
First and 10. Oh, and he might have just saved a touchdown on that deflection. Second down and 10. He was stuffed at the line of scrimmage.
So was that cheerleader.
Third down and 10. They weren't even on the same page on that play. And the punter takes a break from knitting on the sidelines to come in and punt.
His knitting is superb, Grim. That cross-stitching, unbelievable.
He's got the ball now. Let's see what he does with it. Man, what a hit that was. First and 10. And that's a sack. The quarterback has to get rid of the ball there. Second down and long. And he sticks his fingers in the defender's eyes, netting him a pickup of about 8 on the play. Third down and 6. Nice pass. That catch is good for 6 yards. Now here comes the punting unit. You know, punters really do know how to party, Bricks.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, I have pictures that, well, maybe actually shouldn't discuss this on here. They just let that one drop and played safe, and the defense says, we'll take it. And it's first and 10. Does the QB know which team he's on?
I don't even know where I'm at.
What a punishing hit that was. And that's how you make it. Oh, holy Montezuma's revenge. That's a crap your pants and die tackle. Oh, that Montezuma was very vengeful, wasn't he, Bricks? Wonder what made him so mad.
Yeah, it was probably all the diarrhea.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Yeah, they probably ran out of toilet paper when he was in some all-inclusive resort. And he just got so mad and cursed everyone who came to Mexico forever to crap their pants. Sounds like he didn't really think it through because, you know, he should have made it specifically for the owners of the inclusives, but not the guests.
What the fuck are you talking about?
I don't really know right now. What day is it?
And they line up for the extra point. Straight through the uprights. The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
And it's first and ten. Changes the pace by going into a hurry-up.
Does that mean the defense gets into a hurry-up too?
And he's off to the races. First down and one. They stump the clock with their first timeout, leaving them with two in case they need them.
Yeah, just like condoms, hatchets, and wives, huh, Grim?
You know, you just summed up why we don't get together outside of work, Bricks.
I just made me a commentary, but I thought you were supposed to throw the ball forward.
Yeah, you're right. You should.
The quarterback is controlling the clock like the clock is into it. I know I am. And the offense goes into their two-minute drill.
Which coincidentally happens to be Brent's match stunting time.
That's why the girls call me Speedy Gonzalez.
Third down and three.
And timeouts are kind of like condoms, you know, Grim. You got to use them smart if you want to score. Let's see if they did.
The offense wants to speed things up, so it signals a hurry-up.
Yeah, same as Prince's ex-girlfriend signaled when they were dope.
At this point, with multiple interceptions, the QB should just throw. If there were any functioning brain cells before that hit, they're gone now. He's gonna have the IQ of a rutabaga after that hit. And it's first and ten. First down. Looks like they're just gonna pound it up the middle all night, Bricks.
They call that the honeymoon offense.
I'm not gonna touch that one.
That's what she said.
And it's first and ten. At the end of quarter two, it's a blowout. We now go to our halftime show sponsored by Monsanto Industries, makers of great killer products like Roundup. Use it on pesky weeds or neighbors, and they'll be gone by morning. Boy, these guys are going to need to pull off a huge comeback in the second half to win this game. Here comes the kickoff.
Rip the coast! Why do we even come back or bother? This is a waste of our time!
Yeah, if only one team is going to show up, why should we have to?
Good return here to set up the offense. He's gonna be able to run this one back.
I wonder if the kicker was setting up an easy kill.
As he rifles it in there and picks up 7 yards. Second and three. Sandwich. first and 10. Gets the ball, get the first down, and don't die. See, it's really a simple game when it comes down to it. First down and 9. Here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
Oh, nice hit. And it's first and 10. No one was interested in that incomplete pass.
Not a ball's feelings are hurt.
Hey, don't make me explain that balls don't have emotions again, all right? Second down and 10. Warming up. Oh, now the offense is getting kills.
This is a really violent game, guys. It's fantastic.
Must be their lucky day. The offense comes up. Oh, look at this guy break. And this guy runs angry and runs hard. First down.
Okay.
Has only two running backs left, and the defense is licking their lips.
I think they want to hit those last two runners for this outman.
And it's first and 10. And he picks up about 6 on the play. And that'll be second down and 4.
What is this, 80s wrestling?
Third and 2. Position in football, the mighty punter. And he got it off. That's a decent punt. The return. Boom! And it's first and 10. Nice run for a first down. Oh, that was totally uncalled for. And that's why we love the NFL. Tell he's a berserker because he's frozen. That ball was almost intercepted. Second down and 10. third down and, well, good luck. At this rate, the QB's going to have more interceptions than completions.
Oh, and that's what it feels like to...
Oh, holy Montezuma's revenge. That's a crap-your-pants-and-die tackle. Oh, that Montezuma was very vengeful, wasn't he, Briggs? Wonder what made him so mad.
Yeah, it was probably all the diarrhea.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Yeah, they probably ran out of toilet paper when he was in some all-inclusive resort, and he just got so mad and cursed everyone who came to Mexico forever to crap their pants. Sounds like he didn't really think it through, because, you know, he should have made it specifically for the owners of the inclusives, but forget about the guests.
What the fuck are you talking about?
I don't really know right now. What day is it?
Second down and a lot.
Ah, another interception. Geez, you give this guy a bigger paycheck than everybody else combined, you'd expect him not to play like total shit.
His cleats are caked in blood and guts, and he's looking to score. No doubt about it, that guy is dead. He says, I'm taking you with me. First and ten. He's rumbling and stumbling. He could go all the way. Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
The kick is good!
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. Third quarter has ended, and we'll need a huge rally or a high death toll to make this one interesting. First and eight to go. And with another pick, the QB says, I don't know almost throw interceptions, but...
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
Oh, man, he just went off the rails of a crazy train and murdered that guy. Gotta love it.
He should bite his head off for an encore, Grim.
Second down and two. Oh, man, Brooks, you gotta love a player who goes down fighting. Oh, man, he just laid the wood on that guy. And the ref just called a bullshit penalty. The offense is down to their last running back. No rest for the weary. The last runner has to suck it up and hopefully not die. And it's first and 10. Defense says enough of this BS and jumps off sides to lay waste to the referee. Way to go, guys. And it's first and 10.
Don't you just love the sound of bones snapping and cracking? I mean, when they're not your own.
Second down, the size of Brick's wiener.
Hey!
Sorry, partner. And another interception. This quarterback is going to listen to Joy Division and weep tonight. Oh, mama! He just knocked him into the next time zone.
Once he finds his head, he'll be okay.
Well, you mistaken, man. You get up my grill, I'm going to ruin your world. I'm going to wreck it.
First and 10. The receiver explodes and everyone on both sidelines looks very angry.
Well, he owed him a lot of money from what I hit him. Like a lot.
Second down and 10. Close, but no cigar. Oh, and the late hit arrives right on time. When it's your time to go, it's your time. And it's first and 10. He could go all the way. Down and 5. Oh man, the offense called a murder ball. And he just nailed him right on the numbers for a touchdown. Some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth 7.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sitters then.
It's good. When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
First and 10. Get your motor running. It's chainsaw time. That gets me every time. Like a jack in the box, Bricks. You never know when one of those hot potatoes is going to blow. Just crap your pants. The offense has no running backs left, so this becomes a passing only offense.
They can still run it with their QB, right, Ben?
Sure, they can run their QB into the defense that's feasting on runners. Sounds like a good plan, moron.
Hey, watch it!
And it's first and 10. I hope you covered your ears, Briggs, because that was a sonic blast dirty trick. And, oh, devastating hit! You ever supposed to be impartial, but this ref is so dirty, he should be where he's most at home, buried in the dirt. First down and long, and they've had enough. The offense jumps on sides and attacks the ref. First down and a mile. They pick up a nice chunk of yards on that pass play. Second down and more than the QB would like. He's rumbling. Oh, the unstoppable force meets the explodable object. And it's first and 10. Stuck to him like glue. Second down and 10. Crusher right there, folks. It's the 2-minute warning. You know what that means, right, Brix?
Yeah, take a giant whiz and get in a fight in the men's room.
And this field goal is certainly within the kicker's range. Straight through the uprights. Team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five! And he finds open spaces running toward the end zone.
Turn on your jet, you son of a bitch!
And the quarterback goes into a hurry-up offense and calls all the plays from the line of scrimmage from here on out. Off to the races. He's up. Here comes the defense. Someone better buy this guy dinner tonight because he just saved a touchdown with that tackle. And they quickly call a timeout to stop the clock. First down and one. And that's just a great run for a touchdown.
Why didn't the skeleton dance in the rock club, man?
Should be easy, but with kickers, you never know. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
They need a good return here to set up the offense.
A one-legged girl baboon could have kicked that ball farther.
Yeah, that's the first time I heard you compliment your wife, Bricks.
First and 10. He's not going down. And like Brix's bowels, he is loose and heading for the end zone. He could go all the way. And with one timeout remaining, the defense has to get something going here. And it's first and 10. Here, just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. Straight through the uprights. Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a frog in my bed.
This guy's a brick shithouse. And the offense goes into a hurry up to pick up the pace of the game. He's rumbling and stumbling. He could go all the way. Going for two. Bam! Gutsy run for the conversion. The kicker's going to have to kick the ball just right so his team can recover it. Free and has open field in front of him. The Maniacs deliver a bloody win for the Motor City. And let's hear what the game's MVP has to say.
Yeah, right. Go home to your fast cars, million-dollar mansions, endorsement deals, and your beautiful trophy wives, you losers.
At least they're not attached to a loser like me.
All right, losers, let's hear what the game's MVP has to say.
Hey, man, I was hanging on the middle now. You know what?
Grim Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. and all the folks at Evil SN want to thank you for watching this presentation of the Mutant Football League.
Today's game was brought to you by the Hexon Oil Corporation. We drill it, spill it, and kill it so you...